All right, and welcome again, since I've already done this once, but had the wrong screen up. And I'll switch that over where we can see this. All right, nice. And this is Sweet Pea, the game I, and Robite's Hunger, game I made from scratch. Everything I learned with Unity, I've been plugging into this game. Started off with the idea of my girlfriend knitted some little fruits, vegetables, and she had these two peas with like eyes and a mouth, so it was like hard eyes, and she didn't know what to really do with them, so she just put them around the house, and I was make it into a game, a character, and that's kind of, and she not a big gamer, but so I wanted to make something that wasn't inherently for gamers, but just something that would be fun for anyone to just pick up and play. And got into these game jams, which were basically challenges to create a game from scratch in X amount of days, usually like 3 days, a week, 2 weeks, a month, and there's practice ones, so there's rules ones, you could win prizes, there's non-rules ones, you could find something a little bit for everybody if you're looking for that. And yeah, let's get into what I made. That little song that I had to turn down was made in Sonic Pi, which is a coding it uses Ruby as a coding language, but it's basically built for making songs and has instruments built into it, so, and synthesizers, and you just code the notes. You could code sheet music if you so choose. So that's something I'm learning that's going to be fun to really implement into this. Got some resolution choices, which seem to disappear when I build the game, so I need to figure that out. Have just a basic menu, and yeah. So let's get into it. First level, you need to collect 14 coins. Originally, these coins would just get instantly picked up as soon as you step on these guys' heads, which they have a little bit of an AI to them. As you see, they'll stop. He'll go to the other edge, kind of wait 3 seconds, or with like a second, I guess, and then come back. But if he's ever so close to you, he'll just continue to follow you, or not follow you. He won't hurt you. He could push you. I think that's his, just push you off the edge, but he won't inherently hurt you. Collect those coins. Those coins will have a delay on them, so they don't appear right away. That was a little fix I did. So I'm gonna collect 14 coins and these little bouncy mushrooms. Oh, you have a double jump, so up is jump and down is jump, and left and right, those are the two, and these will shoot you up like a little mushroom pop. Kind of got the idea from Half-Life with there's this kind of alien muscle looking thing on the ground that you can step on and it just flings you in the air. That's kind of the idea I got. And this little trigger, which is like a light that I made. I think it's a light. I gotta really remake that, make it look more distinguishable. But these will appear 3 piece coins, and then after 3 seconds, we'll see the next level. This one I had a lot of fun with these little radar things on the top to show you where your baby peas were, which is the whole point of collecting it. Collecting your baby peas that got taken away from Robite. And you need to trigger a certain events for things to happen. For instance, like how these get triggered, that platform gets triggered, and then your baby pea appears, one of them. And there's another trigger that sets off the boss right there. And Yeah, you got it. There's the other baby pea, and as soon as you touch them, they come up to your thing, your little pea pod. And you gotta go talk to your corn friend now. Which all this needs to be. Alright, he can grab you at that point, which is just death. So that's a little fix. I want to have him appear maybe fully to the right, so you can have a chance to go to the left and not get just taken. Like that. And these guys, these will fall off and just appear again. So it's not you're getting new enemies, you're just getting the same enemies. Because if you step on this guy and you get him go off the edge, but he doesn't want to push him off the edge, he'll just come back. So, and this guy goes slow. I don't know how slow. I might make him faster. I might change that sound effect. Okay, so this is your friend Cobbs, and told those peas. So basically, if you ever lose him, that's what he's saying. Like, get pushed off, they'll just appear again. And you gotta touch them each time, even if they do fall off. So, lose that guy. Girl.
So, especially.
So, a little claw. Big metal claw come and take away your baby piece. Oh my god. You gotta freeze those guys. So, he's basically saying you couldn't fight him off with his cane. But there's a button that appears that can damage the robot, and it'll appear after you talk to him. And let's see him grab you. So this is an enum state that I coded for, like, enumeration state. So there's like four different states he goes through. Attacking, which is him grabbing you. And idle, which is him just following you. And hurt, which is that. And he loses. I do want you to be able to have ability to collect these. It's in the works, so, which would be fun. I don't know if he glitches when you grab him after this state, because it's, yeah, so he's a little broken right now. We'll come back to him. And, oh yeah, there's a R2-D2 robot that I had do the sound effects, which was very fun. So those all the robot sounds were just my R2-D2. That robot guy.
So let's press E.
Just thought it weakens him. I don't know why he's making the attack sound. It's a new glitch. But that's why I'm doing this, so I can fix things. So let's hurt you. Great. You don't say. Right, let's lose our baby peas. Talk to Cobbs. That's almost destroyed. The last press should do it once you've done it. Beaten robot, you must get your kids to safety. So let's just bring these guys. See if they follow us. It's so fun to see them shoot. Yeah, I lost one, so. I'll just take care of this guy. That animation was fun to do. And you just gotta bring him to that big mushroom, and you win the game. That would be it. So let's click this last coin. Get your baby peas. I've just resulted to like just blasting one at a time. Oh no. So. Usually, I might have to fix some of this, of their ability to jump. Oh, thank God. And there it is. You win. You got a little stuff you can play around with and drive around the wind sign. credits. It was all me, all from scratch. If I chose any code that was from anything, I watched it and did it by hand. So I would get muscle memory and dedicated to my sweet pea. Yeah, that was fun to make, and I'm continually making it. I'm gonna see what I can build from it, improve on it. If you guys know of anything, I've got links in my page, and also VladMGC on YouTube did a little playthrough, which I appreciate. So check him out too. It's on my itch page, where you can find the game to play. Awesome. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.